Hey guys, it has been a super, super long week. I'm just here at 10:30 at night, eating some banana bread. It's been a very, very long week. But I'm gonna plan and pace a little better next week. And some very exciting things are happening, so stay tuned. I will see you guys later. Hey guys, so I've woken up really late and I'm looking and feeling pretty rough. Here's the tuft from my surgery in November. It's getting there. I've got an awful headache, but I think it's just because I'm exhausted. It's already 11 and I'm only just having breakfast because I couldn't bring myself to get out of bed. My alarm went off at 9 and I went back to sleep till 20 past 10. So, gonna have a shower and get ready, and then I'm off to my dad's for a family barbecue, which is nice, but I'm looking forward to it. But equally, I really want to go back to bed. So I'm all ready and off out to the barbecue, but I'm really not feeling very well. My head's really hurting. I just feel a bit sick and woozy and weird, so we'll see how I go. But I was meant to deliver some books as well, but I don't think that's gonna happen. Might just kind of get there, eat and come home. See how I feel, because I want to see everyone, but I'm no good to anyone feeling like this. Hey guys, what have I done today? Loads. This morning I kind of cleared up and was trying to do some Avon work, but I was not with it in the slightest. I went to deliver a brochure to this lady who was like a 30-minute round-trip drive. And I got a little bit lost on the way there, and got there only to return and a few hours later get a text from a lady that was not the lady saying I delivered it to the wrong house. Luckily the lady I was meant to deliver it to found it really funny and was able to go pick it up, so I didn't have to go back, but oh, that was a bit of a nightmare. This afternoon I went for a swim and had a bit of a moment because I was just struggling with it, and I just feel really weak, and I feel like I'm trying to do so much to get stronger, but it's just not happening the way I want it to. But these things take time, and I'll give it another go and see. So went for a swim and then we went to have dinner, and they served me undercooked rice. It just wasn't cooked. And the girl wasn't even sorry about it. She was like, this is how it comes. So that meant I didn't have very much for dinner. But we came home and I had some vegan chocolate cake and some edamame beans and stuff. So feeling a little fuller, and then just watched some telly with my mum. But I've got an early morning as I've got a puppy all day tomorrow, so definitely an early night. I will see you tomorrow. It was an early morning this morning, but managed to get up and had a good dog walk when it was still cool, and then came back and we're just kind of playing and resting. I also got this in the post today, which is super cool. It's from A Spoonful of Crafting, and they give craft sets to people with chronic illnesses. So this is a heart decoupage necklace, so I'm looking forward to doing that when I actually end up having some free time this week. the rest of the day, kind of just gonna chill with the puppy. It's a hard life.
Samuel Lewis Weather.
Hey, it's been a really long day.
I'm just really exhausted, I think. Got up early, had the dog all day, trying to do some other bits as well. But I watched all my friends graduate this afternoon and it was so lovely and I'm so proud of them all. But it got to me a bit. Because obviously I should have been graduating today with them. If it wasn't for my health stuff, that's where I'd be. But I'm in a totally different place. And it just made me worry about going back to uni and stuff as well, just that I'll never achieve it and that I'll struggle too much. But I'm allowed to have this moment because I'm allowed to have this moment and it's okay to have this moment. But then tomorrow I need to get over it and forget about what could have been, should have been, would have been, and just do what I can to get the best out of me, because I want to go back and I want to achieve it despite all the odds, you know. In 2 years time I can be there doing it and this will all have been worth it, and that's what I've got to keep in my head. So yeah, a tough one today, but so happy for all my friends. And I know they're going to do amazing things. And eventually I'll catch up. Hopefully.
I ache a lot. But I'm ready for work, I think. So I think I'm ready. I'll see you in a bit. Hey guys, so sorry I didn't do much of a video yesterday. I was at work most of the day and then literally I got home from work, had some dinner and read Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban until I went to bed. Rock and roll. And then we went to the cinema and we saw Despicable Me 3, which was really good. I really liked it. Came home and I just haven't been feeling great. Like, this whole week I've just felt so exhausted, like beyond even my normal levels of exhaustion. So one of my other guide leaders sent me home early. It's really rare that I'll be home until like at least 10:30 on a Wednesday night, but it's 9:15 and I'm here. I'm gonna go straight up to bed, I think. But it was the last week of term, so it was a bit of a shame, but I got some really nice presents from the girls and their parents, like just little bags and boxes. You know, being a guide leader is voluntary and it's so nice to kind of, we don't expect presents at all, but it's so nice to kind of be thanked and appreciated a bit, even if it is all wine and chocolate that I can't have. One of the girls has got me a torch, which is actually really useful for camp in a couple of weeks. So, that's amazing. Aw, oh, I'm really chuffed that it wasn't all chocolate. I got a torch and a nice reed diffuser and a photo frame and a couple of bottles. So, that's really sweet. Hey guys, so
So today we are going to London. First we're going to go to Deliciously Ella's Deli for lunch, then we are seeing School of Rock, and then this evening we are going to the Para-Athletics. So, very busy day. I'm really not feeling very well. I feel really sick and I really don't feel good. I just feel weird. My blood pressure's alright, but I don't know what's going on. But I've also managed to not only cut myself with my own toenail, but then rip the toenail off that cut me. So I was going to be wearing sensible trainers to help my knees, but that's really going to hurt my toe. So I'm now wearing sandals. So it's not been great morning, but I did find my Oyster card, which I thought I'd lost, and I printed it off the tickets, and all before the 10:30. So, and I called both venues about my walker. The theatre didn't answer, but they're just going to have to lump it. the Para-Athletics were fine with it, so that's fine. But it's going to be a very long day, and I really don't know how I'm going to cope. We'll see how it goes, shall we? Hey guys, so I'm feeling a super amount better. I was absolutely exhausted this morning, but I've been to work. Well, at first I completely forgotten that I had to see the dog I look after today. So went to visit her before work, which cheered me up, and then had work from 12 to 5. Just sat in the 4DX and watched people watching all the Planet of the Apes and then half of Dunkirk. So was an okay day, feeling a lot better and a lot less achy though. During work my arm really had some weird pain in it. It was not very nice. But yeah, so yesterday was so good, despite the fact of how exhausted it is. When we go back to the Para-Athletics on Saturday, I'm definitely taking my wheelchair because there is no way I'm doing that much walking again. It was not good. By the end of the night, Mike was pushing me along on my walk because I just couldn't handle it anymore. But School of Rock was incredible. I mean, the kids play the instruments and
The lady who took us up and down in the lift was saying that the girl that played bass had never played bass and learned it in like 3 weeks. It's just insane. These kids are so incredibly talented. So you got to go and see it. It's really, really good. So if you wanna be a teacher's pet, then baby, you just better forget it. If you want to see a video of me singing that song, I will link it up here with some other cool people several years ago. Then the para athletics was really cool. It was great to show Mike the Olympic Stadium because he's never been there before. They've got the little hero village, and I had a little go at wheelchair racing, which was so difficult. And then we went into the stadium and saw some brilliant races and some throwing and some jumping. We saw a long jump, a couple of shot puts, club throw, and then lots of different runs. But two highlights of the night, I think, were seeing Hannah Cockcroft, Kare, Adenegan and Carly Tate all in one race. So the atmosphere in the stadium was crazy. And then Hannah Cockcroft won, of course. I love her. And I think Kare came third in that one. And then the other one was watching Georgie Hermitage get a world record. That was insane. It was so, so good. And also there was a guy who, they were doing the 800 meters and he was right down the back. We didn't think he was going to get anywhere near. And then four guys crossed the line almost exactly the same time. One of them was him and we were like, oh, he's never going to get it. And then he came third and the whole crowd just went crazy. He didn't even realize his name had been called until he heard the crowd. So it was a really, really good night. And I'm really looking forward to going again on tomorrow. But yeah, it was a very busy day that really, really wore me out. So hope you enjoyed coming along on this week with me, guys. And I promise that I won't leave it so long before my next video like I did this time. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of me, hit the subscribe button. I will see you later, guys.